The Beef Quality Assurance Program grew out of a movement in the mid-80s to produce healthier cattle.
We started seeing a lot of antibiotic residues in cattle, realized that that wasn't good, and we needed to do something about it.
From that original concern, the educational program has expanded to cover nearly all aspects of the cattle industry, all with the goal of keeping costs down and marketability high.
We can spend a dollar at the producer level to fix a problem, but if we don't fix it there and it goes on to the next level, which would be the packer, it's going to cost us $10 to fix that problem. And if we don't catch it there and it makes it all the way to the consumer, it's going to cost us $100 or more to fix that same problem that we could have fixed for a dollar at the producer level.
Producers can implement things that will reduce those negative impacts. And all those things generally have a direct or indirect influence on the price of the cattle or on animal performance, animal health. They all go hand in hand with beef quality and wholesomeness.
So these are things that most of our producers in the state are going to be doing anyhow or are trying to be a part of. Why not go ahead and get certified and just make it part of your marketing strategy?
Well, that's a good point. Most producers are doing many of the beef quality assurance practices, those things that minimize the impact, negative impact on health and wholesomeness and so on. The other thing that they get out of it is that, the record keeping is required as part of, or recommended as part of the Beef Quality Assurance Program. And, good record keeping is power. You have access to, let's say, for example, treatment records. And how many times have we all gone out into the cow herd and see a cow, let's say, for example, with foot rot and wonder if she has ever been treated before? And so, it could be that the hired man or hired person treated that animal 2 weeks ago, but without a record, you wouldn't know.
Right. So,
if you pull an animal up and say, "Well, it's time to market that animal," they may have not gone beyond the withdrawal time of that drug that they were treated with, and so to take them to market that day, if you don't check the records, you don't have a record of that. Right. You are risking the possibility of a volatile drug residue. Mm-hmm. And so those records are one of many things that producers can get out of a program like this.
Producers looking to be BQA certified, or even simply to brush up on the program, will have several opportunities from late August through mid-September. OSU Cooperative Extension, the Oklahoma Beef Council, and the Noble Foundation will be teaming up to host BQA field days in the four regions of the state.
The traditional meetings, we'd sit down and go through a PowerPoint presentation of about 2.5 hours. This will be a little bit different since we're doing it as a field day. It'll all kind of be a little more hands-on type of approach. We'll be out in the field looking at some cattle, talking about different things.
They may just come to the meeting and say, "Hey, I'm doing 95% of this. All I have, if I add this and that, I can document that I'm doing my share, because beef quality assurance is everyone's business and I'm doing my part."
The field days are scheduled for the Tulsa Fairgrounds on August 24th, the Caddo County Fairgrounds on September 8th, Woodward County Fairgrounds on September 13th, and the Pittsburgh County Expo Center on September 15th. Registration each day begins at 8:30, with the event wrapping up by mid-afternoon. Now, if you can't make the daytime events, a traditional class will be offered at night on the same dates. If you'd like more information, visit our website, sunup.okstate.edu, and click on show links.